跟大家来学习如何认识佛教。
How to understand Buddhism？
先为大家简单的说明
Last time, mentioned.
看第一章，佛教啊，非宗教。
Buddhism is not a religion.
也是非哲学，
A
而为今世所必须的。
But it is
这个
needed
就是
by
这个
today's world.
星期，简单来为大家说明
Last
佛
week,
教对我们意义重大在哪里？我们修
why is
佛教
Buddhism
重要
important?
在哪里？
What is the
原因，
benefits of practicing Buddhism?
明的历史学家他
Mentioned last week there was a famous
能
scholar,
够拯救
historians
这11世纪的
Arnold Toynbee,
这个
a way to
宗
save
教，
the society of 20
明
centuries,
佛法
Mahayana
如何
Buddhism,
解决这个问题。这个是已经给大
and
家
just
上一次啊做一个简单的报告。那今天要跟大家来说明的呢，
So today, we would like to learn about,
我们看下面。
like to learn about,
今天要跟大家来讲解的，跟大家来
want
分
to talk
享
about
的，
today
就是什么是佛。
is Buddha.
大家都知道
What is
啊，
Buddha?
佛这一个字呢，
All know that.
是从印度古文啊，就是梵文
Word came from Indian, ancient Indian,
翻译过来。
Sanskrit. Sanskrit.
那翻译过来翻成
And
意思呢，
after it was being translated,
就是智者。
Chinese meaning,
智者就是觉。
English meaning is the Buddha means
智者就
wise person.
觉，觉者就是觉。
Second is a awakened.
你的福报才能够现前。
Two words, wise and awakened.
在佛法里面呢，是一个非
With
常
wisdom, you can have the fortune of being,
所以从
because
印
being
度
awakened to the reality is a
来
great fortune.
到呢，那对我们意义呢就很大了。
That this wording, we understand that these two factors are very important.
你说你走
Like
得
a
辛
person
苦，
who walk on a street,
说辛苦一定很辛苦。
if they walk without a leg,
能不能自在？
two legs, if they walk without a leg,
什么
can
意
they
思
be
呢？就是说，
they walk freely,
你在这个环
conveniently?
境里面，特别这个
Therefore,
不但是污染的
是
区域，
current,
但这是
就是
从
like
杀盗邪淫的
our current
成熟
era.
时代。不守信用
This era where everyone has a high tendency I precept
a
lot of arrogance
你没有智慧，你没有觉悟，你没有福报，
你
说你能不能生存？
misconduct
很难。
Bands being
所以呢，
without wisdom,
所以为大家
without
来说明介绍。为什
Fortune
么
is hard,
for 佛教
us to
为
save.
今世所必须的呢？
Why is Buddhism needed by
今天
today?
为大家做一个解释，让
It is important.
我为什么要学佛？佛对我有什么意义？将来对我的前
Sure.
途
Does Buddhism, that Buddhism mean to me? How does that affect my future outlook in something we were talking
about?
So how is it relevant?
那现在我们先来看一下下面的那一章。为什么当年呢，这个
Why did,
这个字呢，
word Buddha
为什么当年翻译的时
was not when they translate from Indian to China, Chinese, why didn't they just say, you know, one who's awakened, the one who's wise? Why do they just use tone, original tone? instead of the meaning. You know, in the past, when we translate sutra, there are actually rules that governs it. There are five things they cannot translate. Bufan, five exemptions from translations. That one of the included in one of these exemptions. Itself, it's very, but if it's very deep, vast meaning. Any a place. Chinese and also English. It's one word to replace. So therefore, it's as a site to explain it. Okay. So, for example, the Dharani, compassion, Dharani, Da Bei Zhou, in Guan Yin, Bodhisattva Guan Yin, or Mani Padme Hum, they all have they all directly transliterate into Chinese or English. Amitabha is also directly translated. Why don't we translate it? Look at Shakyamuni Buddha, look at his work, you know, his teachings and the results of his teachings, felt contributions to us, to us. So, when we hear his name, it invokes his deeds, and easier to relate. Simple explanation why we don't translate the meaning, that we take the name itself directly in another language. People will ask that, why can't you translate Buddha? Meaning? So many meanings. Aspects. So, as a student, must know but yeah, and his wisdom. His wisdom, when we describe his wisdom, we can't use conventional wisdom. Very, there's a lot of differences in terms of scale and level of wisdom. So we had to emphasize that we don't stick to the word wisdom itself. What does Buddha mean? Yes, it means wisdom. What kind of wisdom? Important to have a concept. If Buddha's wisdom is to be summarized, very important for